Hello, I'm Lissa Evans. I wrote the book Their Finest Hour and a Half, which is adapted into the film Their Finest. There were sort of multiple births of this. I've always been interested in the home front ever since reading a book about it when I was 12, and I've gradually added to my knowledge of it, almost as if I had memories of my own of it. I know so much about it. I'm so interested in it. And then I worked in radio and television myself and came to relish that very peculiar world behind the camera, where extraordinarily trivial things seem massively important when you're there. And I started wondering if, during the war, those trivial things seemed just as important. You know, when bombs were actually dropping outside the studio, had it seemed just important, you know, what colour the leading man's tie was? And I started researching and I started thinking, what would it have been like to write a film during the war, to make a film during the war, a time so serious and so extraordinary, and yet you were entirely engaged in doing trivial things. And that was the birth of the idea. I wanted to write a character to whom the whole film would be new. So we'd be seeing it through the eyes of the reader. So I wanted to bring a character in who hadn't worked in film at all. And I had worked in radio and television. I knew what it was like to be a woman behind the scenes, a woman also involved in the banter and the sort of almost cutthroat banter of the writer's room, which is incredibly enjoyable and which I relish hugely, but which is deeply competitive and very, very male. And I wanted to see how somebody entirely new to that world, not hugely pushy, not hugely self-confident, could nevertheless discover her own abilities and come to relish the aspects of it that I relished. And I thought Gemma just did absolutely beautifully because Catherine isn't, she's not a sort of ball-breaking pioneer. She's somebody rather quiet and rather diffident, but who discovers something in herself which is which she can contribute and which is a talent. I researched this to the extent that I felt I was living in the 1940s when I wrote it. And it is an homage because people produced extraordinary things during the war. People who had no sleep that night, who might have lost relatives, who had half the relatives half a world away, nevertheless managed to get up in the morning and focus their minds on the tiny trivia of a film production. You know, where a light should fall, how a line should be spoken, what colour a costume should be, and they managed to produce something truthful and interesting and new in some ways. Well, as the war progressed, films became more realistic and more reflective of the lives of the people living through the war. So it is a tribute to people doing extraordinary things in extraordinary times.